थैंक यू सर।
In second act, first scene we see meeting of Sebastian and Antonio. In next we see Malvolio with characteristic churlishness delivers Olivia's ring to Viola. Actually, Olivia, you can say she has an experience of love at first sight when she meets Viola in previous act, and she is impressed by the way Cesario speaks, and she falls in love with Cesario, and she doesn't know that Cesario is not a man, actually that's a disguised Viola. She sends a ring. Malvolio delivers Olivia's ring to Viola and concludes in soliloquy that her outside has charmed Olivia. Her response is to pity the lady for her in her own character. She can only for in her own character she can show a fellow feeling which she cannot as Cesario, her general reflections about women's frailty. Similarly, associate Olivia and herself and prevent her giving all her sympathy to the one and none to other. This soliloquy is the pivot of the play. While a soliloquy that sums up the complicated and fantastic situation. In this soliloquy, there is the line, "Our frailty is the cause, not we, for such as we are made of, such we be." Here a pronoun we is actually used for women. "My master loves her dearly, and I, too a master, a monster, fond as much on him, and she seems to dote on me. What will become of this? As I am man, my state is desperate for my master's love. As I am woman, what thriftless sighs shall poor Olivia breathe? O time, thou must untangle this knot. It is too hard a knot for me to untie." So first time she smells that her purpose was to serve, but instead of serving her duke, she is causing a problem. And problem is Olivia has liked her, and Olivia has sent her a ring as token of love. In third scene of second act, we see that this act opens in a restive, relaxed spirit, where Sir Toby, Sir Andrew, each fooling after his fashion, and the clown contributing his professional nonsense and a song which introduces the play's leading theme of love into the scene of good life. That's a song of actually clown. "Oh, mistress mine, where are you roaming?" That's a song which is being referred here. Clown sings a song, and Malvolio has his orders from Olivia, but he carries them out in exactly the same churlish manner as he returned the ring to Viola. His first speech consists of aggressive rhetorical questions, of which it is a pleasure to see Sir Toby score. Sir Toby and the clown pursue the argument in song, reducing him to indignant interjections, adds to his soreness, which he vents on Maria as he withdraws. He has given an offense to all of them. He thinks that if he speaks on behalf of Olivia, so he has power of Olivia. That's the mistaken view of Malvolio, which causes problem for him. It is taken as he has given offense to all of them and their conspiracy against him begins the moment he leaves the stage. Ab yahi wo point hai jis waqt ye Epicurean group plan karta hai ki Malvolio ko maza chakhana chahiye. To maza chakhane ka matlab yahi hai ki wo uske sath ek shararat karna chahte. Maria, unfolding her more promising plan, brings him by the way of reminder that Olivia is much out of quiet after her interview with Voila to explain why she sent Malvolio to suppress the singing. It is reiterated that Malvolio's weakness is self-control. Malvolio, because he has Malvolio's weakness is self-control, and a full of display of this is promised when he finds the forged letter. I mean, to play with him, and it will be exposed that whatever he pretends, seriousness, self-discipline, etc., these are only in words. Malvolio's character is also taken as a criticism on Puritan mind and Puritan soul, because his ideals of seriousness and duty, they resemble the ideals of Puritan. Critics of Shakespeare, and you can say supporters of Puritan, sometimes you can say criticize the dramatist for belittling the character of Malvolio. When Maria goes, the knights subside into their unusual element, drink, but not without further reminder of Toby's and Maria's mutual appreciation and Saint Andrew's courtship of Olivia, so unprofitable to himself. From the small odds at Olivia's house, the play moves to mourning at Orsino's, from a foolish wooer to a noble one. That's, you can say, a fourth scene of second act, where Duke appears as somehow a changed man. Even the very first line, "Give me some music." No, good morrow, friends. So the man who was self-absorbed in his first speech, in opening speech of fourth scene of second act, he is a bit changed. And Duke and Voila, they are exchanging their ideas about love. This is the first sight of Voila with Orsino since she confided her secret love in an aside and a soliloquy. Voila's love is covertly expressed in two different ways, as Cesario's love as Cesario's love for a lady of the Duke's years and complexion, and Cesario's sister's love for a man to whom she never told it. Actually, Voila, when she is serving as Cesario, she concocts a story that she has a sister. You can see that actually she had a brother, but she has taken the disguise of Cesario. No, she claims that she has a sister, and she thinks that her sister loves a man. And through this, you can say secret talk, actually, she shares her own feelings for Duke. And she tells if her sister will be in her place, in his place, she would love Duke in this way. And that's the point where Duke starts loving, you can say, Cesario's sister. I shared when she actually makes a story of her sister. She tells that she never told her love, but let concealment like a worm in the bud feed on her damask cheek. She pinned in thought, and with the green and yellow melancholy, she sat like patience on a monument, smiling a grief. Was not this love indeed? We men may say more, swear more, but indeed our shows are more than will, for still we prove much in our words but little in our love. So in these lines she challenges the notion of love that is expressed, rather the love which is experienced and which has the feature of patience, that love is actually owned by Boileau. The emphasis of the scene is upon Boileau, as in the second dialogue after song, she is nearer disclosing her love, but she does not restrain. But she does the restraint and shares as a story of her sister. Instead of saying that she has fallen in love with Duke, she claims that her sister prefers this and that. Duke is moved by the story and by its telling and gets more curious about her sister. Action returns to the conspiracy against Malvolio in next scene. Before he sees the letter, even before he appears, Malvolio is indulging his ambitious and substantial daydreams. He has a habit of daydreaming, and his daydream is to marry Olivia. They include not only marrying Olivia and thereby becoming Count Malvolio, but also from that exalted position, reproving Sir Toby. So Count banke wo Toby ko jo hai सरजनिश करना चाहता है, ये उसका एक ड्रीम है. Consequently, Sir Toby adds comedy with his robust indignation at what he never looked to overhear. Letter is added fuel to an already blazing imagination, yet its riddling verse slows Malvolio down to a ludicrous deliberateness. As Malvolio hurries away to make sure of Olivia and greatness, Sir Toby voluntarily gives up his liberty to Maria, followed in the offer, as in all things, by Sir Andrew, who seems to have forgotten that he is suitor to Olivia. The whole mood of this episode is hilarious, gaiety. I mean, in gay mood, they are actually planning all this thing to play with that character Malvolio. Maria, as I mentioned, through her intelligence, she becomes, you can say, the most significant part of that group. Even her position is the lower one. In this way, in letter, there was actually a plan that Malvolio will put on yellow stockings. And yellow color is the color that Olivia hates. And she actually, you can say, detests snobbery display, etc. And Malvolio, because he looked, you can say, serious, responsible. So she had a word of admiration for him. But now Maria writes a letter in the handwriting of Olivia and delivers that letter in the chamber of Malvolio. Malvolio reads this letter. In this letter, there is a desire of Olivia to see Malvolio in yellow stockings. And we can say that's the first thing that to create a bad image of Malvolio, as well as play with his seriousness. And next act, Viola and Clown, they are talking, and Viola's quibbling exchange with Clown has every appearance of a warming up after a theatrical interval. It adds nothing to the plot, and Clown's remark about universal folly is of debatable importance. As he says that the lady Olivia has no folly, she will keep no fool, sir, till she be married. And fools are as like husbands as pilchards are to herrings. The husbands, the bigger. So foolery foolery, sir, does walk about the orb like the sun, it shines everywhere. Foolery does walk about the orb like the sun, it shines everywhere, but the fool should be as oft with your master as with my mistress. I think I saw your wisdom there. Idea is which is being called debatable. Ye folly jo hai wo har jagah hai, hum aankhon se duniya bari padi hai jahan. Aur dusra ye ki sabse bade ahmak jo hain wo husband hote hain. Ye point hai Clown ke jisko debatable jo hai wo qarar diya ja raha hai. Viola responds in this way: this fellow is wise enough to play the fool, and to do that well craves a kind of wit. Mean Clown is fool, but Clown craves a kind of wit. He must observe their mood, on whom he jests, the quality of persons and the time, and like the haggard, check at every feather that comes before his eye. So these lines are thought remarkable for the art of clowning, as well as for comic appearance of characters. His side strokes at Olivia, Orsino, and Viola are equally part of his act. All this he evidently delivered without the least ill will, meaning he had no evil notion behind. This act calls for the lively aspect of Viola, and so the tone is set. Some exchange of Viola and Clown, and is maintained when she is accosted by Sir Toby, Sir Andrew. Sir Toby's extravagant style permits more quibbling and makes a smooth transition to Viola's complimentary style, which impresses Sir Andrew. When Viola and Olivia are left alone, fine speaking gives way to plain speaking. I mean, because when they were before others, they were speaking differently. Now, Olivia has a chance. Olivia has a chance to express her love for disguised Viola. Cesario. Olivia brushes aside the formal compliment, declares her love, and entreats an answer. It is she who is pitiable, blushing for her forwardness. She declares her love, and after that, having sent the ring, struggling to accept Cesario's indifference, stoically at last pouring out her love, Viola does pity her. Her situation.
Sir, sir, slides nahi show ho rahi.
Why?
I don't know. So blank aa raha hai sab kuch. बस वॉइस आ रही है आपकी.
ओके, इज इट विजिबल?
यस सर,
सर अब हो रही है.
Her situation would be positively painful if her emotion had not been kept under control. Then Sir Toby encourages Sir Andrew to send the Count's youth a challenge. Because now it is revealed that Olivia has fallen in love with the Count. And Count here means Cesario. Count's youth means Cesario. Count is Duke himself. And Maria reports that Malvolio does obey every point of the letter and is even now on his way to Olivia. So, Sir Toby gets money out of Andrew. His project of duel is a piece of mischief making for sheer fun's sake. I mean, he does not want to harm Andrew, but he thinks that it will be more love for fun. As you can see, first source of amusement was letter writing and playing a prank with Malvolio. Now second fun giving episode is Sir Andrew's challenge of duel to Cesario. Antonio has followed Sebastian to Orsino's city. That's another scene where we see Sebastian has entered the city and Antonio is following his friend Sebastian. As Antonio resolved to do in it, his loyalty and Sebastian's gratitude stress the theme of friendship, which becomes another aspect of love. The verse expresses the earnestness of both men, and this fits the graver subject of Antonio's own danger. His history marks him as a brave, impetuous, but not lawless. He gives Sebastian his purse, a deed which sticks in our minds. The next scene is composed of four situations. Malvolio's delusion, Olivia's unawareness of Cesario's identity, Viola, and Sir Andrew's unawareness of Toby's practice, Antonio's mistaking of Cesario's for Sebastian. These are the situations. First situation is under the false impression of letter. Malvolio is in a delusion that Olivia loves him. And to please his beloved Olivia, our imaginary beloved Olivia, he is putting on yellow color. Second episode is Olivia is not aware that Cesario is not a man. Actually, she is a girl, Voila. And Andrew is unaware of Toby's practice. And Toby's practice is only, you can say, pleasure-seeking practice. He neither wants to harm anyone, not to make fool anyone, and not to, you can say, support Andrew wholeheartedly for the marriage of Andrew and Olivia. Last is Antonio makes a mistake of Cesario when he sees her and calls her Sebastian. Antonio, जहर अपने दोस्त सेबेस्टियन को ढूंढते हुए यहाँ तक पहुंचा है और उसे यहाँ पर वायला जो है वो सेजेरियो के डिस्गाइज में नजर आती है, जिसे वो फौरन ही सेबेस्टियन समझ लेता है क्योंकि दोनों ट्विन ब्रदर्स सिस्टर हैं, दोनों की शक्लें एक जैसी हैं। तो ओलिविया इज इंडीड इन लव एज मालवोलियो फैंसीज विद हिम। इट इज अ होली कॉमिक इंटरव्यू, vigorously and economically dramatized. Its keynote is Malvolio's invincible assurance. He does not even begin to perceive that he is made a fool, he is made an ass. His soliloquy relishes the audience and anticipates his clash with Sir Toby. Malvolio is allowed to stalk off. We do not see him taken to his dark room, nor bother how Sir Toby's decision is carried out. Maria is invented the plot against Malvolio. Sir Toby is now directing both that and the duel. Invention was of Maria, but you can say command is in the hand of Sir Toby. Toby, it may be because of his position, he describes each adversary to the other with inventive gusto. Sir Andrew's comic discomfiture as this center of the challenge makes him the butt of the joke. Voila, who was given that challenge, shows a natural and feminine anxiety but not terror. Zahir hai ki चैलेंज तो सेजेरियो को दिया जा रहा है और सेजेरियो को एक मर्द समझ के री एंड्रियो ने ड्यूअल का चैलेंज दिया है कि दोनों में से जो विन करेगा वो ओलिविया को हासिल करेगा, लेकिन वॉयला को ये है कि वो कैसे जो है वो एंड्रियो की साथ ड्यूअल लड़ेगी जबकि वो तो सिर्फ एक लड़की है और सिर्फ उसने गेटअप जो है सेजेरियो का लिया हुआ है। तो फेमिनिन एंजाइटी इज देयर बट शी इज नॉट terrified. Terror is not seen there. In next act we see when Sebastian is mistaken as Cesario by Andrew and Toby, even Maria and what's name? Antonio mistakenly has seized Cesario. Antonio's intervention is welcome to unite Voila's adventures with Sebastian's adventure. Voila's adventure as Cesario's Sebastian adventures to search her sister everywhere. And no sooner has Antonio, a man of principle and a loving friend, appeared than the officers has come in to arrest him. यानी अंटोनियो जब आता है और सिजेरियो के साथ, तो ड्यूक के आदमी जो है वो उसे अरेस्ट कर ले, क्योंकि क्यों अरेस्ट करते हैं, दैट्स अ सरप्राइज इवन दो हिज डेंजर हैज बीन इन्फॉर्म्ड, ही हैज मिस्टेकन वायला फॉर सेबेस्टियन एंड आस्क फॉर द रिटर्न ऑफ हिज पर्स एंड वायला डिनाइज ऑल नॉलेज ऑफ इट आर ऑफ हिम, क्योंकि उसने पहले खुद ही मोहब्बत में आके तो अपना जो पर्स था वो सेबेस्टियन के हवाले किया था, जब सेबेस्टियन चला गया अब वो सेबेस्टियन के पीछे शहर में आया, यहाँ उसको सिजारियो नजर आया, उसने पर्स के बारे में पूछा, उसने इनकार ही कर दिया क्योंकि उसे इस बारे में कुछ इल्म नहीं था, इस वजह से दोनों में एक झगड़ा जो है वो चल रहा है। लेकिन असल जो इशू है वो डिफरेंट है, और जो ड्यूक है उस पर एक चार्ज है दैट ही हैज हार्म्ड द नेफ्यू ऑफ अंटोनियो, दैट्स व्हाई अंटोनियो इज नॉट ऑन गुड टर्म्स विद द ड्यूक ऑर्सिनो एंड ड्यूक्स मैन एक्चुअली अरेस्ट ही। इन फोर्थ एक्ट अगेन वी सी क्लाउन एक्चुअली इन वी कैन से एट ड्यूक इज सीन एट ओलिविया'स हाउस, क्लाउन जो है वो दोनों तरफ ही रहता है, कभी ओलिविया की तरफ कभी ऑर्सिनो की तरफ। क्लाउन इज अ वेल चूज़न इंटरलोक्यूटर फॉर सेबेस्टियन, क्योंकि ये क्लाउन है जो सेबेस्टियन को देख के जो है उसे करार देता है कि ये सिजेरियो। हिज नेचुरल शार्पनेस इंडल्जेस इटसेल्फ इन आयरन्स, he wants Sebastian's patience thin and puts him in a fit state to deal with Sir Andrew, and he comes in handy to fetch Olivia to the quarrel. So actually Sir Andrew gave a challenge to Cesario, a challenge of duel, but before you can say Andrew and Cesario they meet each other, Duke and Clown are meeting, then Sir Andrew arrives there and Sir Andrew strikes Sebastian, who responds, and in this way you can say a duel is carried. Andrew comes in handy to fetch Sebastian defies Sir Toby manfully. Olivia dismisses him with dignity, and though the comic mood persists in her mistaking Sebastian for Voila, the scene ends with delight and harmony. No sooner have the mistakes of identity begun than the romantic knitting up begins too. Mistake of identity, because Olivia thinks that Sebastian is Cesario, and she as I mentioned that first both Sebastian and Andrews they have a fight, and afterwards Toby Sir Toby and Sebastian, they also draw their sword and they are ready to, you can say, fight. At that moment, Olivia is brought by a clown. Olivia enters and she orders, "Out of my sight, be not offended, dear Cesario. Roads back, be gone." So, to hear these words, Sir Toby, Sir Andrew, Fabian, all they go. And because she loves Cesario, she does not want to see him in pain. And she expresses her love for him. And he responds, "How runs the string? or I am mad, or else this is a dream. Let fancy steal my sense in leaf strip, if it be thus to dream, still let me sleep. It looks to him dreamlike situation that someone whom he has never met in life is, you can say, sharing all love to him. So he thinks that it's a dream, and if it's a dream, it's so beautiful, he wants to remain in that dream for long. Here, Malvolio is imprisoned. Malvolio's imprisonment appears an interlude. It is less Malvolio scene than the clown scene, because clowns, you can say, takes revenge of him, makes fun of him, and he's skipping versatility in being first at Topaz and then himself, and then for a while both together. Carries the scene along briskly, but as Sir Toby's wish to be well rid of this knavery shows. Well rid of this knavery, and knavery is actually Malvolio, and that's the actually command of Sir Toby to rid of this knavery. His Sebastian soliloquy takes up his aside with this mingling of wonder and delight reinforced by the imagery. Of the glorious sun and this accident and flood of fortune. That's the soliloquy of Sebastian, where actually his question is, where is Antonio? But he feels that if he has not found yet Antonio, he has found, you can say, a world of wonder. In that world, you can say, he has that flood of fortune. He also concludes his soliloquy that there is something in it that is deceiving. He thinks that there may be something wrong and he should avoid it. But before he, you can say, makes up his mind to act otherwise, Olivia enters. When Olivia enters, he is, you can say, under the spell of her personality and love. And now, whatever Olivia commands, he follows. She says, she asks him for marriage, and he responds, I will follow this good man and go with you, and having sworn truth, ever will be true. Then lead the way, good father, and heavens so shine that they may fairly know this act of mine. In you can say their first meeting, Viola asked Olivia that she must have a copy behind. And now she is calling Sebastian the father of